Hello world, it's Rahul. Welcome back guys to Deep Learning Tutorial. So guys, here today we are gonna discuss about convolutional neural networks. So what is CNN and why it is so important to us? So guys, they are a kind of deep neural network which were designed from biologically driven models. So what researchers found was how a human perceives an image into the brain is in different layers, and that's how this CNN model has designed. And hence, it has been very efficient for all the image processing pattern recognition kind of applications. Here is very basic structure of how convolutional neural network looks like. So guys, your input is an image, and the task that you are dealing with here is recognizing a bird. And what you see here is that you have taken an input which is 2D input, and then the next layer you actually see bunch of convolution layers, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 outputs. So what does that mean? You are using 5 filters, apply them throughout the filter, throughout the image. Each filter gives you one feature map. And so in this layer, you have 5 such features map. So as name says, it is the core block of CNN. And what it does is, it takes bunch of filters which will get applied to the given input image and create different activation features in that input image. So what we have input as a parameter, which will be, let's say, width times height of the input for 2D image. Then we have kernels, and these could be of any dimensions. Let's say we have 3x3 filter, and it will have the same depth as the input. Then we have a number of kernels, which is basically number of activation filters which we are going to generate for given input image. So let's say that is N. Once these set of kernels are applied to the input and output is generated from the convolutional, which will have the same spatial dimension as the input and depth of the output would be the same as number of kernels. Now, two things here to talk about the spatial dimension, that it is also dependent on the factor called strides and padding. So guys, strides decide how you want to process your pixel. So if I have stride value of 1, I am processing each and every pixel, so dimension is same as input. But let's say if I have stride of 2, then I will consider every other pixel in the image, which, you know, take my output dimension W by 2 to H by 2. So stride will basically act as a downsampling. So here, one filter could be extracting the edges of an image, one filter could be extracting the colors of an image, and so on so forth. So as I explained just now, that after passing filters through our input image, we are getting the output, but with lower dimension. So you must have one question over here, that we are losing some of our data, then how can we train our model on those sorts of informations? So guys, here padding comes into the picture to preserve the same information. So if you want to make the output also 5x5, what we have to do is, we have to add the padding all the 4 sides to an input image and then apply the filter over this so that we can get 5x5 matrix and don't lose any of the information. So guys, let's understand how is this working with an example. So here we have an input image of 5x5. Let's divide this image into pixel value, which will be total 25 vector points. And I'm using a 3x3 convolution, or you can see it as filter as well. So in order to apply convolution, all we have to do is that place this filter on top of input image. So here we have 3x3 filter. Let's take this 3x3 initially. So when we take this 3x3, now you see over here, all we have to do is we have to multiply this term with respect to this particular cell. So in the first case, you will see that 2 will be multiplied with 0, so I will get 0. Then we will add the next value, this 0 will be multiplied with 1 and we will get as 1. Then 2 will be multiplied with 3 and we get it as 6. Now we will go to the next row, and this 0 will be multiplied with 2 and we get it as 0. And then this 2 will be multiplied with 1 and we get 2. Then multiply 0 with 2 and we get it as 0. Again, we will go to the next cell. Now, 1 multiplied by 2 will be 2, 2 multiplied with 2 will be 4, and for last cell, we will multiply this one with 3 and get it as 3. So, by taking summation of all these values, we will get 17. And this 17 will be placed in a new matrix which will be passed to next layer, or we can call it as output layer of our convolution. Now, what we will do is, we will place the filter to the next column as we are considering our stride value as 1. So, we have our filter only with 1 value. So, it means we will go and select our next cell by jumping 1 to the right like this. Now, let's do this process for each and every cells. We will make the stride jump 1 by 1, but once it comes over the end, we have to come step down. That basically we have to start it from here. Every time we have to do one step down after completing the end of the image. So here we have one formula as well. And guys, this is only applicable if our stride value is 1. Let's say input has n number of dimension and filter has f number of dimension. Then output would be n minus f plus 1. Let's say input is 5 cross 5 and filter is 3 cross 3. Then output would be 5 minus 3 plus 1, that is 3, what we have just find out. So guys, this is how convolution layer behaves, where we pass filters to the image and try to extract certain features. Let's come to sketch layer. But before that, guys, let me tell you that every convolution layer has additional term with it, and that is ReLU, or what we call is the non-linear activation layer. Let's understand why we add this term to convolution layer. So here we are using ReLU because it's supposed to bring the non-linearity into our network. By definition, when we are seeing something, we have lot of non-linearity into our environment. Let's say when I'm looking at the chair, that chair can be at various angle, but I can still recognize it as a chair in my brain. So my brain can process that non-linearity. But convolution by definition is linear function, so we need to add non-linearity, and that's why the ReLU comes into the picture. So what that will do is, it will take the input data and put 0 for everything which is less than 0 or equal to 0 and positive state as it is. So that's where it brings the non-linearity in the data, and hence it removes the overfitting probability and makes it more adaptable to the real world case. So guys, now next layer is pooling layer. We will see what is pooling layer in detail. Now, what I want you to understand is, let's assume that what pooling layer does is, it does some kind of shrinking and it takes the original output and shrinks it. But how it shrinks it, we will see in a while. Again, we have bunch of convolution filters plus ReLU layer, then pooling layer, and at last, fully connected layer. So here, output of pooling becomes input for the next stage. So we will take this as an input, apply some convolution on that and get some output and continue in this way. Now let's dive deeper into what is pooling layer. What does the pooling layer actually do? So here, whatever input we are getting, guys, when I'm saying input, it doesn't mean I'm talking about the actual input. Input can be at any layer. So here, our input to pooling layer would be output from convolution. So let's say I'm taking a window size of 2x2. Then what it is going to do is, it's going to take every 2x2 window in my convolution and minimize it to 1 pixel. Now, there are different ways of doing pooling. The most common way is max pooling or average. Let's see how does this work. Let's say we have this 2x2 pooling layer, and it has some value something like this. And if I want to take max of this, then it would be my maximum value. So it brings non-linearity and also down samples. So guys, I'm continuously saying down sample. So now why is down sampling important to us? As most of us already know that CNN is known for its compute heavy and its memory heavy issue. And with pooling, we are able to reduce the size and hence reduce the computational complexity and the memory complexity. Let's apply pooling on our data what we got after applying convolution. So here our window will be 2 cross 2, Let's hover over this and check the maximum value. So 18 is our maximum number. Now let's move by one stride value towards right and check max for this window. So here max value is 18 again. Now we go to the down and check for each window till it reaches to the end. Hence, we will get the output as shown on the screen. So guys, this kind of network keeps continuing. So one of the another most commonly used layers, which is fully connected layer. So objective of fully connected layer is to identify or detect the final output categories. And that's why it is in output stages. So in this layer, every node at the input is connected to the coefficients and it processes all of the data what it receives and create these branches of output datas. And we pick the top 2 or 3 using some probability distribution algorithm like a softmax according to the number of classes used. Guys, one thing to note here is we used to flatten our output in fully connected layer. So if we are having one output as 15 cross 15, then we will flatten this and make it as 255 data points. So from here, we will have dense connections, no more sparse connections. So now we have a feed forward networks from this point of view. Guys, one thing to note here is that CNN has one major property of sparse connectivity. So let's understand what does it mean and why are we using sparse connections. So guys, in an image, we don't really care about the interaction between a pixel at that left topmost corner and the right bottom corner. So there is a sky in leftmost corner and there is a road here at the rightmost corner. We would want to capture the neighborhood around that pixel, not really capturing it with the entire image. That's why we don't want all the inputs to contribute for a particular layer. We only want small neighborhood to contribute. Now guys, I will just talk little bit about applications. So applications are like everywhere. As I said, it's image processing pattern recognition. So wherever there is a camera, we can see an application of CNN. So surveillance is a place where we want to recognize objects or classify it. So it can be anything from object detection to, let's say, people detection. Let's consider a surveillance camera at the bank or any secret places where we want to see who is coming in, who is coming out, what all things that particular person is carrying with him, whether that is allowed to carry or not. So all that kind of surveillance data uses CNN to classify those people or object to keep the data into network and then compare it to a set of data sets. Then we have very hot topic, that is autonomous vehicle driving, as Tesla has already launched it few years back and now it started functioning in India as well. So we basically use CNN for doing segmentation of entire image which our automotive is seen. So vehicle is looking into the front and it will see, okay, there is a road, here is the sidewalks, here is the pedestrian, is something crossing, and based on that it is going to decide where to, which part to take and where to drive. Even in L3 autonomous, it does object detection, pedestrian detection, traffic side of your mission. Next could be something like mobile application. In mobile application, we have image recognition lock system which uses CNN network for recognizing the image. And if it recognizes correctly, then phone is unlocked. Then we have this gesture control system as well, where CNN is just targeting each and every gesture and it has a set of filtered coefficient on each and every gestures. And it can say, okay, when I'm saying I'm sliding my window, I'm sliding my tab or I'm deleting it, it will control that through the mobile phone. So guys, we can see that applications are almost everywhere in today's world, from recognizing the image to doing something with the image and playing around with the image. So with that, I would like to wrap up this session on just an introduction to CNN. We will carry on this video with more details on the architecture stuff and everything else. I hope you guys like this particular video. Thank you guys for your time. Do like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Happy learning and stay safe.